This video was brought to you and booked on Indie Amplify. Go download to the description to get your music video reacted to, grab a feature, or any of the other services that I have to offer. You can even sign up using my referral link to offer your very own services to get paid as an independent creator. All right, beginning back up, bow. I sound like the dude from the Wild Thornberries. Yo, what is going on, everybody? It is your boy Crypt. Welcome back to another video. And today, my man Dax just dropped an Eminem Venom remix. And we're gonna hop on into it. My live chat is telling me there's a big mouth in the sky, and I like seeing big mouths in the skies. So let's dive on into it. Blah. I'll try and break down as much as I can, but obviously I'm gonna miss a lot of things because it's the first time listening.
I know I'm usually shitting on you, but I'm sort of worried about you, man. I mean, if Eminem does ever hit you up, you won't have any bars left.
Okay. Last time, okay? Last time.
Okay, Blackie, last time. But promise me that after this, you'll go see a doctor and get some help, okay?
Dr. Dre?
No, you fucking monkey, a real doctor! Get off!
All right. Very, very interesting introduction right there. I do often wonder about that. Like, my man has done so many remixes and, like, so many of these one-liner punchlines. Like, it's awesome he's had the motivation and the inspiration to be doing all this stuff. Like, I find myself running out of shit to say. So, it's awesome that his brain constantly works in that kind of way. Alright, let's see how this Venom remix is going.
Yeah, I'm about to spit this venom. My heart's full of rage, packed up aggression. I'm about to tear this beat a new asshole. I don't think they learned their lesson. How the fuck you wanna talk rap in this generation, but I don't get mentioned? Like, I ain't done more than 95% of these niggas independent. This level is not reachable. They ain't never seen a man climb this high. No hooks, my fate is the truth. I spit, I catch from a view that's fisheye. Riptides as I wake them.
Ooh, I like that. I like that my hooks are like my lines. I catch from the fisheye, like the fisheye lens, and it like zoomed in as a fisheye lens. Obviously, you got the double entendres from hooks, as in lyrical hooks, like musical hooks, and fishing hooks. I think it's a punchline that's been made several times, but I like the fisheye lens that he did right there.
I catch from a view that's fisheye. Riptides as I wave them goodbye. You can't swim tsunamis. This beat's getting flipped acrobatically, bitch. I'm catching bodies. Loaded up. I'm a son of a...
He getting flipped acrobatically. I'm catching the bodies. See, he does a good job at, like, showing you what his bars are saying.
Bodies. Loaded up. I'm a son of a gun. Pistol whipping everyone who is not in my caliber. Verbal bullets get to flying on automatic. You can dodge if you are not a challenger. I revolve around and orbit the earth. You not planted anywhere on my calendar. Smith's words in the west and on leap years. I'm out sniping these lines out in Africa. Desert Eagle. Gas.
Okay, the Smith & Wesson, he's got the Dodge Challenger line, talking about guns and some of these right here.
In the Western Elite gears, I'm out sniping these lines out in Africa. Desert Eagle, gas and chambers within...
The Desert Eagle, obviously, he's got some. We got some gun punchlines in here.
Desert Eagle, gas and chambers within your cerebral. Semi-democratic, even Mike Pence couldn't second or amend. Bars this lethal, fuck peace. They in the Middle East for the oil. Root of evil, blood on the flag, they Bin Laden. So who's saying that it's not about the soil?
Okay, they're on the flag, they Bin Laden, and so Hussein, it's not about the soil. Obviously, Osama Bin Laden, Saddam Hussein. We got some evil dictatorships mentioned throughout this. Obviously, overseas, talking about the oil crises and stuff that used to happen back in the day, like the Gulf War. So we got some stuff going on right here. I'm liking this, and also like the Second Amendment bar that kind of tied up all the gun references right there at the
put
end.
Put oil, root of evil, blood on the flag, they Bin Laden. So Hussein, that it's not about the soil. I recoil because I'm not with a politic. If I don't get voted in office, I'm done with the remix and paying these homages, because I don't see no other candidate fit for position with this type of confidence. Who came in the game off the bench and been killing these people and ain't got a scholarship, just to be honest. When most of the comments is positive, negative feedback is fueled to achieve more accomplishments. Hoping they don't put a sock in it, please do the opposite, fan the flame. Fuck if they don't, I'ma add my own oxygen. I don't need oxygen, bitch, I'm monogamous. Marry the game like Solomon. My shit is real and dependent on me to produce and continue my reign, and that's why
I really like that, the fan the flame bar. I put my own ox in it because oxygen is needed to keep a flame fiery alive. And I've seen my man been catching a lot of slack lately, specifically on TikTok for the Super Gremlin remix. Like, it's been kind of crazy how much of that I've actually seen, because of like he rapped a little bit faster on that, and people just... they just hate fast rap now. Like, it's just a common fact that people don't like it as much as they used to, and they don't listen as much as they used to when it comes to that kind of stuff. So I'm liking that he's saying, like, the negative feedback, even though it's scarce and few and far between, I do use that to build the flame, and I want people to fan that flame and just keep it going.
Monogamous, married the game, but like Solomon, my shit is real and dependent on me to produce and continue my reign. And that's why my temple's the booth. I'm feeling diabetic in this generation because they sugarcoating all the truth, not to mention the...
That's a good one. I'm diabetic in this generation because of sugarcoating all the truth. Diabetics are the high sugar intake and their sugar drops, their blood sugar and stuff.
Because they cool. Sugarcoating all the truth, not to mention the penicillin and the ink's blue. So like Duke, I bomb on these devils who never follow through. Fuck, I'm official.
Damn, I bomb on these devils that never follow through. Duke is the blue devils. My pen is illin, penicillin. I've heard that punchline several times, but I just wanted to point
devils
that out.
Who never follow through. Fuck, I'm official.
And the devils that never follow through. Like I said, he's doing a good job of like showing you what his fucking bars mean. That's a good skill trait
blue,
to have.
So like Duke, I bomb on these devils who never follow through. Fuck, I'm official. The government knows it. Central intelligence has me on watch. They got a micro inside of the phone, so I don't talk like the hands on a clock. I don't do virtual. I'm in reality. You're in the meta. Slate to a box. Fungible token. Hot for a moment. Everybody gets to fuck like a dot. The illegitimate rat child. My style is an LLC. Limited and in the company of greats with no backing or liability. If you want to make bets, I'm ABC. That's alpha. You baked up. Bait on me, I don't miss, and if I remix a hit, the mind shifts to process it. Please repeat, cause I spit that venom. My bite is extreme.
I'm glad he didn't do the hook. I hate that hook so much. I'm glad he just gave it a nice little ode right there and just kept moving.
My bite is extreme. It may affect you depending on facts within the entanglement I call a scheme. It could be bars on the surface of deep that talk in the language of chasing your dreams. It's just some ridiculous shit to remind you that that's a totally different league. That venom. And it's not gonna stop. I got 100 of these in the bag. You better pray I don't drop. I see the evil, I see the rituals, I see the sinister plots. Yeah, so I stay at war with these demons, a sinner, but I'm still a soldier for God. You better give me space, son, I'm a star. Wars are fought and waged over art. If they invade dirt like Darth, there will be no minds left to spark. I don't gotta act to play my part. I'ma shake peers. I go to ham to let them think they'll ever get near. Like Broadway, bitch, I'ma set the stage. Grease elbow.
Okay, I heard a William Shakespeare bar in there. I heard a Hamlet bar in there. I think I heard a Macbeth bar in there, maybe somewhere along those lines. So I think I talk about this every action where Dax has this thing where he does, where he'll pick a topic and then for like 4 to 6 bars, he'll really focus on that one specific topic and try to make some of these compound words or these AABB rhyme schemes and like these words blend all together to really show you what he's saying with some of these things.
If they invade dirt like Darth, they will...
And then obviously the invader.
No mind left to spark. I don't gotta act to play my part. I'ma shake peers. I go to ham to let them think they'll ever get near. Like Broadway, bitch, I'ma set the stage. Grease elbows, then go investigate. I think something's going on in this day and age. Cause we stare while the problems escalate. And I estimate that.
Ooh, I like that. We stare while the problems escalate. Stairs, escalators. That was kind of cool right there. And then obviously I shake peers, Shakespeare. That was where the Shakespeare reference came from. There's just so much, man. There's obviously so much to try to break down with these, and I'm gonna inevitably miss a ton of them, but I'm trying to catch as much as possible because as
in order this day and age, because we stare while the problems escalate, and I estimate that in 33 years and 33 days the waters arise and the climate will say that the humans on earth didn't care to change for their children and now have to suffer the fate to suffocate. But back to the rap shit, if I get too real, you pigs will squeal and say Dax going batshit. Well, if I am, I got the perfect average. ERA spells error, and this
like
one ain't
that.
Golden if Dax can't have it, because no one spits this truth, and even if they wanted to, their minds can't grasp it. What happened? Rap used to be a skillful passion, now they robbing it just like baskets. The ice and the cream and the focus on fashion has got the masses divided in social classes, obsessed with the size of asses, living a fake life in Calabasas to feel valid that everybody thinks they want until they finally have it. Open eyes, this is demise. We are
Oh shit, that, I thought I was gonna end right there. So I like the Baskin Robbins line right there. It's all about the ice, the cream. They're robbing like
Baskin. Social classes, obsessed with the size of asses, living a fake life in Calabasas to feel valid that everybody thinks they want until they finally have it. Open eyes, this is demise. We are currently living inside fucked up times. Mandates engage the rise of violent crime, depression rates, and death by suicide. It awaits to lower chakras and divide while the normalcy of privacy is deprived. In the cancel culture, vultures sit and hide and then gas the light with lies on their device. And people cry till eyes are realized within the choice to pick a side, not fall in line like sheep who can't decide where the grass is green to put the pest aside. And the best advice that I can now provide is
ooh, and where the grass is green to put the pest aside. Obviously people put pesticides in grass where the grass is greener, but pest aside, put the pests aside. Sorry, there's a lot going on. This is a long
decide where the grass is green to put the pest aside. And the best advice
advice that I can now provide is to live your life the best you can despite this evil, crooked roller coaster ride that you're guaranteed not to survive.
All right, bit excessive at the end. I do like that a lot. That, you know, just do your best to survive in life on this crooked-ass roller coaster that you're guaranteed not to survive. Like, we're all going to fucking die one day. So, really, does any of this matter? So, then that's the message that we take away at the end of that one. Let me know how you guys felt about this one right here. Long reaction on this one. A lot of stuff to break down. Yeah, it's crazy, man. Dude's just rapping like crazy lately. He's dropping one of these every week. And I don't know how he does it. Like, I know I can't rap that much. I just run out of shit to say. I just start rapping about shit that doesn't mean shit. I hope he doesn't fall down that path. I want him to continue to rap about stuff that really means stuff to him, like stuff that's on his album. But yeah, that's the end of this one, guys. Till next time, it has been your boy Crypt, and I'm signing out, and I'll see you guys in the next video.